Professor Alfred Vella, Rector of the University of Malta, Professors Landry and Fattore, President and Vice President of the Mediterranean Neuroscience Society, Professor Giuseppe Di Giovanni, President of the 2017 MNS meeting, distinguished participants, dear students, dear friends. Il giornata taiba u marba f'Malta. Good morning and welcome to Malta. It is my pleasure to welcome you to Malta for the 6th Mediterranean Neuroscience Conference. While I augur you a most constructive and successful conference, I do hope you will have some time to enjoy the rich cultural and historical heritage of our islands. Let me begin by congratulating the Mediterranean Neuroscience Society and the Malta Neuroscience Network of the University of Malta and your collaborators for organizing this important conference. I am informed that there are approximately 450 delegates participating in this conference, including many students. I feel very privileged to be among the brains of the Mediterranean region and the world while you are focusing your attention on the incredible power of the human brain. It is reassuring to know that thanks to these conferences, over the years, you have gone beyond sharing good practices. In fact, you have also developed strong friendships and created new opportunities for dialogue and connection. In today's world, where conflicts and uncertainty seem to be of constant concern, especially within the Mediterranean region, this kind of relationship building is very essential. In fact, I would like to commend you for giving visibility to another side of the Mediterranean region as a place where knowledge is being nurtured, wisdom is being gained, and progress is being promoted in the field of neuroscience. I believe that we need to give more attention to neuroscience now, more than ever before, because as we all know, mental and neurological disorders are an area of increasing concern. The World Health Organization tells us that 1 in 4 people in the world will be affected by mental or neurological disorders at some point or other in their lives. Moreover, we are told that mental and neurological disorders are among the leading causes of ill health and disability worldwide. These indicators make it very clear that the work you are doing is indispensable. I feel proud to be here amongst you because your sector is transforming the quality of life for countless people through medical innovations and increased expertise. However, I believe that such advancements can only achieve the best results when scientists and researchers are willing to share their breakthroughs with one another. I believe that progress can only occur when the scientific community extends itself beyond the confines of individual institutions by transcending the borders of our nations. Progress only occurs when we work together in truly collaborative ways at national, regional, and global levels. Progress only occurs when dialogue among diverse professionals is encouraged and sustained, especially through strategies for science diplomacy. When I say science diplomacy, I'm referring to the process of collaboration to achieve scientific and medical advances for the benefit of our societies and nations. Today's conference is a perfect example of how such diplomacy through scientific dialogue and sharing can take place. Moreover, it is an example of the fundamental importance of relationship building, which is the cornerstone of all peaceful, productive, and sustainable development. Science diplomacy is crucial to continue improving the lives of the citizens of the world. Your breakthroughs and innovation should serve all humanity. However, in this context, an important question comes to my mind. Are all our authorities ensuring that your breakthroughs and innovations are made accessible to all humanity? I would like to take this opportunity to urge all our authorities to ensure that the benefits of your work are made accessible to all their members of society, respective of who they are and where they come from. I'm pleased to know that through your engagement at this conference, you are openly sharing and building upon profound scientific knowledge by which you are strengthening the global community. When you, as scientists, experts, and academics, share your learning, you send a strong message that cooperation is more important than competition, that your connections are stronger than divisions, and that your commitment to collaborative processes is more powerful than the threat of conflict. In this way, you are contributing to a culture of inclusive and participatory knowledge building, which is a vital component of a healthy and sustainable culture of peace. I believe that these collaborative processes must continue to take place, so that these collaborative processes will value the unique contributions of stakeholders from the Global North and the Global South. I must know that your collaboration is a strong contribution to the implementation of the United Nations Agenda 2030 and its sustainable goals. In particular, goal number 3, which prioritizes health and well-being for all humanity. In order to achieve this essential goal, your collaborations must embrace all experiences, expertise, and good practices from both shores of our Mediterranean region and beyond. Therefore, I urge you to do more to encourage greater synergies between our respective universities and research centers. In so doing, we can be secure in the knowledge that we are working together for the greater good of all. Undoubtedly, when we work together, our potential to achieve positive results grows. When we work together, we show that no matter our differences, we are united in the pursuit of the common good, and that we are united by common values to reach a common goal. These should be the values that define us, values that represent our determination to be of service to others. I urge you to be aware of the influence that our values have and the effects that they have on patients and service users while receiving your support and care. I believe that in all sectors of human life, it is the dignity of the individual that must be our primary concern. Respect for the dignity of one another must be the cornerstone of a global culture of peaceful collaboration and the ethical foundation of all scientific and social development. The level of dignity and respect we show to the vulnerable is a direct reflection of the solidarity that we need to continue to strengthen within our communities and our societies. Our focus on the dignity of others must also include wider strategies within our nations, but also internationally. This approach will prioritize the holistic well-being of individuals and their families who are living with chronic or lifelong conditions. Let me take an example. The ways that we respond to autism and other neurodevelopmental conditions should be a reminder that we need to be mindful of the ways that our societies are responding to the needs of these people. In this context, some questions come to mind. In what ways are these people being included within society? How is their participation being promoted and safeguarded? How are we ensuring that they can enjoy a good quality of life and holistic well-being? I urge you to discuss and evaluate our commitment to ensure full dignity to all by emphasizing the need for effective social strategies which promote the dignity of all people, and in this case, particularly people living with mental and neurological conditions. Let me take this opportunity to emphasize that the contributions of civil society to safeguard human dignity are essential. By giving greater visibility for issues of mental and neurological health in your respective ways, you are being true activists of human dignity. I urge you to continue to strengthen the connections you have created as professionals and practitioners with civil society organizations. I believe that it is vital that different stakeholders continue to come together, linking different countries, diverse disciplines, and specific sectors together. In this way, we shall be promoting a holistic approach to mental and neurological health. Such a holistic approach leads to process of reviewing and potentially improving legislation and policy for the benefit of the 450 million people currently living with mental and neurological conditions. Before concluding, let me share a few words with the students present at this conference. I'm sure that this conference will open up many opportunities for you. You will meet leading figures in the field of neuroscience. You will also have the chance to network with your peers and educators. This is how dialogue among professionals begins. It is important to make the most of these opportunities, even while you are still students. Finally, I truly believe that by working together, we will continue to promote safe spaces for scientific diplomacy. I am convinced that your cooperation and collaboration can be a driving force to move science to new pastures for the benefit of our global society. I urge you to continue to commit yourselves to the well-being of all humanity, to ensure that the dignity of the human person will always be at the center of all endeavors. I urge you also to continue to value the lived experiences and the scientific and the specific narratives of vulnerable individuals through an inclusive and participative approach to healthcare. Thank you for your attention, and I look forward to the outcomes of this important conference.